Welcome back from that break. You're still watching Checkpoint. My name is Henry Sekanjako. And today I have Nicholas Allcaps. He's a musician based in the US. And we're glad you visited Uganda and passed by Vision Group, Urban TV especially, to say hello to us, encourage us, especially the young people that have passion for music. Nicholas, before we went for break, we're still talking about music recording, a video recording. Mm-hmm. You've supported quite a number of Ugandan musicians.
Yeah.
Recording for their music and of course videos free of charge.
Yeah,
let's pick it from there.
I personally just thought it's the right time to do something different. I saw the figures for some of these big studios were in the millions of dollars. Mm-hmm. And then I saw the figures for some of our smaller studios were, you know, $30, $20. I was like, you know what? That's like, what, like 150 UGX. I was like, you know, we need something in the middle.
Mm.
We need something holy. We need something set apart. We need something for God, you know? Mm. Something that can wake someone up. You've heard WizKid's music now.
Sure, yeah.
Mm. Of course. WizKid's music, when he started, not that good. Some of it was not that good. He got better, but it took time. If someone doesn't believe in you to start out, it's going to be a struggle. But a lot of people don't have the money to go to the studio 5, 6, 8, 10, 12, 13 times before the producer believes in them and can say, oh, hey, you know, let me cut the price a little bit for you, or let me give it to you for free. Some people don't have that money at all. Some people struggle. You know, there's countries in Africa today where the minimum wage for a day is like $1.26. I'm like, what? What? That's very, very low. For a whole day, $1.26. How is that person, even if they're the most talented person in the world, how are they ever going to pay for a studio? That's going to take them years to accomplish one day at the studio. So I said, let's forget the money, because that is not the aim of this. The aim of this is to raise people up, wake people up, bring them to our eyes. Let us help them. If they have that talent, if they have that skill, because I believe music helps us all. Art helps us all. If you are a talent and you are driven and you're passionate and you invigorate us with your style, with your sound, with that energy, you should definitely be on the stage.
Mm. How do you benefit at the end of the day? Because many people believe in scratch your back, you scratch mine.
Mm-hmm.
How do you benefit?
So I really don't benefit at all. If anything, we take 3% full stop. And I'm saying this on camera, so I'm never going to take more than that. We take 3% total. That's 1% for the producer, 1% for the rest of the team as well, and then 1% to keep the business running. Because we still need to pay for the lights. You know, we still have a lot of young artists who we're supporting every day in Uganda, in Ghana, in the US, in the UK, in Scotland, in Edinburgh. We are working with a lot of people who are in the same place where you started. Not you personally, but the artists who we are now raising up.
Mm-hmm.
They're in the same place where you were.
Mm-hmm.
So we're taking 3%, and that is much, much better than any of these other big studios are taking. But that 3% goes towards keeping this running, keeping this going, and waking up the industry. Yeah. And a lot of the artists that we work with, once they get big, I say, hey, come back here. Come work with your little brother. Come work with your little sister. Come work with these people. Because even though they're not where you are now, they are going there. You know? We have to be more humble as people. Mm-hmm. So that is why I really don't get anything from it.
Of course, when you give, non-profit. God also gives you back, pays you in a certain way.
Yeah. You know, I think the biggest way that God has paid me back is some of the beautiful music we've made. Some of the beautiful music we've made. I really enjoy it. I can go to the club now, and or go to a party, or go to an event, or even just at home on YouTube. I'll listen to some music from artists who crashed at my house for 8 weeks, you know? Heavy, intense artists. Like, we have camps, so every year we run camps. If you are talented and you are the biggest thing right now. Mm-hmm. We're gonna give you all of our energy, we're gonna give you all of our money, all of our budget to support you. And I look at these guys, I'm like, wow, they made something that hits me in my heart. Mm. And that's beautiful. It really, really is. Giving to people and being one of those people who can support, it's a great feeling.
Yeah. Tell us about the international acts, musicians that you have worked with, and some of those songs that you know that you produced.
If we want to get big. I'm not going to say names. Let me just sing some songs for you. Mm. She say, do you love me? I tell her only partly. I only love my bed and my mama. Hey. Those? Yeah. Who else? Came from I've been here since last night. Is it any bad type? You know the song. Ladies, that was well for you. Who else? I just been outside things now. Big tunes, big songs. So, you know,
quite a number.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. There's some big names on that list of people who, oh my gosh, That's my sister. I know right now I'm not even speaking English to people who don't love music. Mm. But people who love music, people who need to send me a message because you understand who I'm talking. If you knew all three or four of those artists I just mentioned right there, you need to send me a message because you are at least passionate about music, you know? But for example, Zandy Maz, that's one of my very close friends, one of my really, really good partners in this music thing. The Weeknd, I love his music, and me and his band, we're really, really, you know, we're close. We talk more than I talk to most of my other friends, you know. Who else do we work with? Capaldi, Louis Capaldi, big guy, really, really famous. He Grammy a couple years ago. Tresor, you know Tresor from South Africa, huge. Talented guy, Rick Reezy, Rick Ross, the boss. Oh, him. That's one of the homies. I can send Rick a message right now. I'd be like, yo, Rick, what's popping? And he'll hit me up.
Quite a number. The list is very big.
The list is huge.
And of course, coming back home, who's that person that you'd want to do a collab with?
One of the people I really would love to do a collab with is Spice Diana. I met with her actually a few days ago. We had lunch. And I said, Spice, I think you're a talented person. And I would have said Morris Kyria and Navi or whatever, but we're already working, right? I realized that I've unintentionally been very sexist in my choice of artists I work with. I work with a lot of guys, right? But I said, you know what? I need to work with ladies because they are talented and it is their time right now. I look at artists like Spice Diana and I think, wow, she's selling out 30, 40,000 people shows in Uganda. I'm like, come on. You know, so that is an artist who I look at and I think, wow, already. That's even before we've started working together. We're supposed to be, you know, maybe doing some work together, going on tour, whatever, but like, I would love to do a feature with her. Mm-hmm. I think she's very talented. Last night, we were hanging out with Fik Fameka, really talented guy as well. A. Bryan's, he threw a party, we were there, it was vibey. Even if it's fashion as well. So I run a modeling agency as well called The Black Market Agency on social media. But we've been featured in Vogue 8 times in the last year. We have a really, really close relationship with Vogue Italia right now. And so even if it's not just music, it can be fashion, it can be video, it could be film. I'd love to be on Netflix because I like Netflix. I would love to be on it. I'd love to see myself on Netflix and be like, oh, cool. So, you know, me and Kyria, we're talking about some, have you seen his movie on Netflix, The Girl in the Yellow Jumper? That is the first Ugandan film
on Netflix.
So shout out to the directors on that. That was a big movie, and shout out to Kyria. That was a very, very good movie. So yeah, I want to put another one on there, put another 5 on there, you know. So, whether it's music, whether it's fashion, whether it's design. I design cars. We build houses. I'm an architect as well with my friends too. If you could look at the portfolio I'm building right now, you wouldn't even believe it. It's really crazy.
Mm. What do you think about young artists like Grenade?
Mm. Oh, okay. So like Grenade, Zagazillions. I like those guys. Rick Man Rick. I just watched one of his videos yesterday and I immediately hunted down the videographer because I was like, wow, you know, whether or not the music resonates with me, which it does, those guys are doing something that I think is valuable. They're waking up the youth and they're, you know, they're showing them something. A lot of people in general, but a lot of young people do not have the luxury of even having parents. To them, that's a luxury. They look at people with parents and they're like, wow, you have a mom, you have a dad, wow. Mm. You know? So when I see them and I know that they're mentoring people, I know that their music is resonating with people and it's bringing people out of their suffering, their struggle, they're having a good time. For example, like for example, like Spice Diana, she will organize a show in the village and charge like 3K, 2K, 1K, 5K. And I love that. Mm. I really, really appreciate that.
So you're saying it shouldn't be about just singing.
It's not just about
music.
Money
should be impactful.
Exactly.
It should be speaking to people.
People should be able to afford it. Mm. If you're going to be out there in the village and you want to charge city prices, people can't even come to your show. You're going to have a show of like 200-300 people. Come on, man. Like, that's not what this is about. It's about really energizing people, waking them up, because people have a hard life. I was actually thinking yesterday what it would be like to be a farmer. That's a hard, different, very difficult life. Every day, all day, outside in the sun, looking after plants or animals, that's different, you know? So I think everyone deserves to have that break. Enjoy some music. Have a good time with their friends, with their family. Yeah.
Yeah. Do you write your own music? And when you do, what inspires you? I would still say investor. When I listen to that song,
I'm an investor.
I find it very, you know, interesting.
Yeah.
And, what inspires you before you come up with this music? Can you write your own music?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I write all of my own music. Like I was saying, I also write music for other people. So if you need some songs, send me a message. We've worked with the best of the best of them.
Mm-hmm.
Investor. I wrote for guys like you and me. I wrote for us. I wrote for guys who wake up every morning, put on a suit, and go to work. That was a song for the bosses, you know, because we need love too. You know, people need to know we out here. They need to know we're in the building too.
Mm.
We keep the party going. A lot of times we support a lot of different people in lots of different ways. I realized yesterday, I was like, wow, I bought this person a house. I bought this other person a car. I bought this person a laptop. I bought this person I'm like, you know what? I'm a big deal. And I didn't think I'd get here, but I got here.
Mm.
And I needed to make a song for myself. So Investor is a song for people who pour out into others. People who are selfless. People who say, hey, we run the world and we'll do it with a smile.
Mm.
We're gonna invest in this. We're gonna put what we need to put in there and we're gonna get that money.
Is music profitable?
I'm not going to get into that too deeply. Let me tell you, today, this is early. We're shooting, we're filming early.
Mm.
Let me pause. Before coming here today, I made
22M. Wow.
Honestly.
How did you make it? You performed? You went somewhere and performed? How did you just come?
That's just streams. So I recently just got a deal for Investor, the new song that's coming out.
Okay.
Trace Africa wants it, Channel O wants it, all of these other channels in Tanzania, Ghana, South Africa, Kenya, whatever, they want the song. Uganda, we have Urban, BBS, we have Bukede, we have, people want this song. So you know, they put their bids and I say, look, you can't play my song on your TV station unless you're giving me something. You know, because obviously we're going to get the numbers up because people will listen to the music on TV. They'll want to hear it at the club. They want to hear it on YouTube. They want to see the video. Fine. But you as a station, you need to give me some cash. You know, so even today, for example, I have another thing after this, 8 million. I've been working and I worked for a really long time for free. For free, like
so
really
it's
for
your
free.
Time trip.
It's my time. Amen. Thank you. Thank you, my brother. Thank you. Amen. Yes. Mm. God bless you. It is my time. You know, you don't plant a seed today and expect for it to grow tomorrow. Bamboo, for example, it's an Asian plant. You plant bamboo today and you have to make sure it gets watered and gets sunlight every day for 15 years and you won't see a thing. You won't know if it's working for 15 years. But in that 15th year,
should be up there.
It can grow 15 meters in 6 months. For the first 15 years, nothing. 15 years after that, boom. You know?
Yeah.
So right now is my time. So thank you.
How can Ugandan musicians make money from their music? Because in Uganda it's a bit different.
Yeah.
You find that musicians have to pay radio stations to play their music, TV stations to play their music. How else can they make use of this music so that, you know, it brings for them money?
I'm going to give you a few different tips. This is coming from me. I love you guys, okay? I'm here to support you guys. So let me give you some tips, and I need you, and you need to listen to this. Firstly, when you make a song, do not go to all of these big companies and go, oh, I need you guys to do publishing. Forget that. Release your song by yourself. There is apps. Right now, I could open my phone, and there is apps that you can download and release your music there for free or for cheap. As a new starting musician, okay? So release for free. Do not pay anybody to release for you.
Mm-hmm.
Next, when you release, speak to a videographer, for example. Speak to models, artists, whoever you need to work with or collaborate with on that song. And you're gonna need to really ask them because it's a favor. A lot of people need that money today. But you say, hey, bro, what I have today is nothing. What I can offer you is royalties on this song. So if you release using an app, and I use an app sometimes called Amuse. So if I'm not releasing through a major publicator, I'll release through Amuse, right? If I release with them, I can split up the royalties. Mm-hmm. Royalties are the money that you make every time someone listens to your song.
That's true.
So you split those royalties with the producer, with the videographer, with the models, and you pay nothing or very little for the product, right? So a video that would have cost me $5,000 or 5,000 pounds, which is a lot in UGX, that's like a few millions, like multi-millions in UGX, now is only costing me 1 million, right? Because that is the exact money I need to pay today. Like that 1 million is maybe gonna pay for the boat and we need the boat today. So we need to pay for the boat now. But if you start making those relationships with people, you will find that everything gets so much cheaper. I know it's hard at first if people don't know you, but at least if you have a good product, if you come to me, we make a song for you, and if you want to shoot your video out of like, you know, without me, that's fine. Go do your own thing. But you need to release by yourself, and you need to offer people royalties because a lot of artists don't have the money to give right now at the start of their career. Nobody necessarily has that money to give at the start of their career. But if you offer people royalties and you release by yourself, you'll be fine.
Beautiful.
That is the biggest tip, I promise you. That took me 7 years. 7 years to get to that conclusion. And I'm a very smart person. I'm a very educated person. But I just see, you know, people do it this way. They do it this way. No. How do you say it's bragging? You know, that's just showing off. No. Gwenga gwe. Wubatorena sente. Emiziki jo, release them by yourself, bro. You take a yo weka to etagabantu baradabanji. you know, wogenda ngo gata 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 abantu ku plan yo ezo sente zivali gwe teri muntu mulala zirina kitegeera woba nga tozirina tozi spending.
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
Beautiful. When are you dropping us a hit in Luganda?
Because
you seem to be concentrating more on international, your international fans.
Yeah, you know, people ngenda bakubira yo ruyimba ruri mu Luganda era ngenda bagamba mu Luganda sagara abantu abalala bawulire abazungu nze namwe ngenda bakubira yo ruyimba urujo kubanyenya nyenya you know mujya kuzina when I yo ruyimbo rumu rujya bakanga bakubanze
sizanyiriza nyonze
yeah rujya turi mu
July
2022. Okay. Ngena bawa yoru yimba muna kutano.
Beautiful.
Investor, kwa juhuli deda yoru Muganda wange. Gwe. Tosura butajuhuli da. Na yebano, mwe. Ngena bawa yoru yimba, investor.
Muruganda, wakoze sa kuru Uganda lutono.
Yeah. Lukoze sa. Luganda, you know, that's
yeah, because really in Uganda,
that's my language.
People think that, you know, local music sells more than you know, English songs.
In Uganda, local music sells more.
Mm.
Abroad, it does well, but I don't hear it in the clubs. We have some huge superstars here. I don't hear it in the club.
Mm.
The only people I'm hearing in the club is Burna Boy and WizKid. Where's everyone else? So either, that's why I started the studio idea. Either we don't have the right talent in the right spaces, or only Nigerians can make money in music? That's not true. Wembere wabweru, mpulira Burna, and I hear Wiz. I don't hear anybody else. So for us, if we're being honest, we need to work smarter. That's all it is.
Good.
Spend less money. Even my brothers who are making money, even my sisters who are making, you know, these big, big, big artists, spend less. Mm. Why do you have a team of 50 people? You don't need that. I have a team of 30 people right now. I need that. You might not need a team of 50 people. If I'm not hearing your song when I'm in Sweden, if I'm not hearing your song when I'm in New Jersey, if I'm not hearing your song when I'm in New York, in the Bronx, if I'm not hearing your track, you need less people on your team so you can spend more money on the product so we can hear it at the club.
Beautiful.
Because that is where the magic happens. That's where the party is. That's where people listen to your music. They Shazam it. They look for it. You know, get your song out there.
Nico, we seem to be running out of time, but before we go, let's talk about your love for social media, especially Instagram. I was checking and I found you have about 44.8 million followers.
So
that's about that's a Ugandan population because you're about over 40 million Ugandans.
Yeah, you guys really
how
do
you
your
build
research.
Up these numbers?
So you're a funny guy. Uganda, he's a very, very, very well-researched person. Those followers, that following, Eva, AD, my partners, the people I work with, the people I do business with. If you look at, for example, I posted a picture the other day with a guy called Martin. Martin is one of my good friends, really cool guy, he's an actor. He has 4.8 million followers on social media, and that's just on one. So, you know, maybe like 5, 6 million, 8 million. I don't know. He's really popular. Guys like Kyria, that's another million. Guys like Fick, that's another million. Like, you know? So my personal following is even bigger than I expected it because I work with a lot of people who I could send a DM today and say, hey, bro, please share this song for me. So I might have 500,000 followers or 500, a million followers, whatever. But I can send it to guys and ladies who have another million and another million and another million. We need to work together. I currently manage 90 models in the UK. That is under the Black Market Agency. All of those models that I manage are influencers. They are very, very popular, very famous people in the UK. And if I release a song, or if we shoot a music video, or if I book them a show, or I book them an event, they're putting my name there. That's how you do it.
Mm.
If I was not such a friendly, giving, encouraging person with values and morals and an education, I would struggle to do what I'm doing. But they go hand in hand. The same way school and music goes hand in hand, your schooling, your education, and your passion, they all go together. So yeah, make very necessary and impactful friendships. Make good friends. Don't hang out with the wrong people, because they're just wasting your time and your money.
Sure.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So do you sometimes use these social platforms to promote your music?
I use the social platform to promote my music. I'd be silly not to.
Mm.
At the same time, though, I just like throwing money at stuff, to be honest with you. If I'm a marketer, and I know that marketing actually costs money. People want to come to you as a marketer, as an influencer. They want to get something for free. Stop. It's not going to work. We need money to make the product sell, to make things work. You know, so I do a lot of billboards. I do a lot of advertising that way.
Mm-hmm.
I do a lot of advertising through my friends. I'll say, hey, bro, share this. They'll share it. I'll get like 50 million. I'm like, whoa, thank you. You know, you just have to genuinely is the most important part. Genuinely be friends with the people you're friends with. But also be friends with people who are going to support you, who are going to encourage you, who understand your struggle, who see where you're coming from. Because a lot of people, if you're working in the right space, the people that you're friends with will also understand your journey. I have friends, though, who aren't on that journey. I have my best friend, Jack. I could hit Jack up right now. I could send him a message. I'd be like, bro, send me some money. He'll send me whatever I need.
Yeah.
Because that is my brother. But he is an investor. You feel me? So don't only do music and focus just on music. Think wider. Think bigger than me. Think bigger than anybody that you see on TV. Think bigger than us, because you have the potential. I'm in my 20s right now. I'm going to get older and older and older. You might be younger than me, and you have nothing but potential. So focus on your goals, focus on your ambitions, and you'll get there. You'll get there.
Thank you very much. Finally, we're going to get a bit personal.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, many young girls have been watching.
They're
wondering, is Migo Cubs Barrett is searching?
All right, look, ladies, if you are under 18, leave me alone. If you are over 18, also leave me alone. Uh-huh. I have a girlfriend, and that's the love of my life. I love her so much. Evelyn, you're the best. So
you should expect marriage bans very soon.
Yeah. Look forward to that. Look forward to those. Are we just recording right now, or are we in the editing process?
All right. Nicholas.
Because I'm telling you all the truth.
Nicholas.
Nicholas Nsibirwa,
Nicole Cubs.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
It was a pleasure having you on the show.
Thank you so much.
But before we sign out, your final word to the viewers, especially the upcoming artists, those that are, you know, aspiring to be musicians.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, tell them a word or two to inspire them.
Follow me on social media. I don't have anything else really. I post on Instagram a lot because I'm a model now.
Mm.
Been in Vogue a bunch of times. We really be doing this modeling stuff. So follow me on social media, follow me on Instagram, send me a message today, tomorrow, whenever you see this, and let's work. Because if you are really an artist and you really have that passion, you'll reach me. Even if you have to go to a internet cafe, you'll get to me. And my team will check the messages, we'll send you a message, we'll organize it. I want to hear your voice, and let's really make some music together. Let's do business. Let's get you somewhere in your career. Let's get you somewhere in your life, because this music thing, it works. It takes time, but it works. If you have the time, or even if you don't have the time and it's just, you know, you're getting started, get started. You can do music and other things. You can do music and write a Boda Boda.
Yes, sir.
You can do. I met a guy yesterday. He drove me on a Boda Boda. He's a business graduate. He studied business. And he graduated, and he also studied finance. And he was driving me on a safe board. I was like, wow, this is, you know, you can do two different things at the same time. So send me a message. Let's talk. Let's work together. Other than that, honestly, avoid the party lifestyle when you can. You know, don't be doing too much because you need to pace yourself. If you're going to be a star at these levels, if you're going to be at these levels, you need to pace yourself. Take it slow. Don't drink too much. Avoid drugs. Don't, you know, avoid all of that crazy stuff because your life will become that if that's what you focus on. Whatever you focus on is what your life will become. If you focus on contacting me, you'll reach me, you know? So focus on the positives and you'll get there.
Yeah, and of course, you can share with us your social media handles, Instagram, Twitter, and maybe YouTube.
How can people reach you? No problem. If you check out my Instagram, it's NIKOALLCAPS. Right? Check out my Instagram. And if you check in the bio there, I'm gonna add a link to everything else. So if you go on my Instagram, follow me there, show some love there, follow my other pages as well, they're in my bio. But if you check the link there and you send me a message if you want to do this music, even if you're just getting started, even if you have no songs, send me a message. We don't care. We're just trying to uplift Ugandan people.
That's true.
Because our people need to get up there. Yeah. So the link is there. It's there.
Thank you very much, Nicole Capps. And I wanted to ask, before even I wrap up, what inspired you to come up with that name, Nicole Capps?
My name, Nico, all caps, it Nico comes caps, from, yeah. it's just.
Yes.
Just whenever I see my name, I see it in big letters. I see it in bright letters. Anytime I see my name on a poster, it's just boom, Nico. And I was like, you know what? My name used to be Nico, just Nico. And I was like, no.
I have to add
it's Nico, okay. All caps. If you're going to spell the name, spell it in all caps. And that actually comes from an artist who... Exactly.
Now I get
that
idea.
Exactly. I love watching that happen. I wish I saw that, bro. Like, it came from an artist called MF Doom. Uh-huh. Rest in peace. That guy. If you do nothing else from today, go listen to his music. If you like rap music, listen to MF Doom. He was a... Honestly, one of the best MCs in the world. He used to wear a mask. He was exciting. He was interesting. But he was the guy who inspired me. He said MF Doom, all caps when you spell the man's name. And I was like, you know what? Yeah, Nico, all caps when you spell the man's name.
Beautiful. Thank you very much, Nicole, all caps.
Thank you.
It was good to have you on this show.
I appreciate
it. And we're looking forward to having you again.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate you. Yeah.
Of course, yeah. That's all we had time for on Checkpoint. I'm sure you've learned quite a lot, especially those of you that are upcoming artists. The youth, avoid drugs and be very innovative. Invest. Get a good friends, good company that will keep you going. My name is Henry Sekanjako. Good night.